That's right, strongisland.com. We are back, Real Talk Live. DJ Tracktion just killed it. I am LA the Boss, CEO of strongisland.com. And with us, we have a very special guest, Last Measure. What's up, man?
What's up, strongisland.com? What's good?
Cool, man. So, I know you from last week's show. And you had a nice track, kind of like old school, hard, simple, but like just, you know what I'm saying?
Straight to the point,
exactly.
You know, very, very, very 90s feel to that right there.
Yeah.
That's what I thought. As soon as I heard it, I'm like, all right, it's like it's early Nas type beat, like that type era right there. Like, yeah. I can get with that.
Yeah, definitely. That's where I come from, you know, that golden era.
Exactly. Well, that's what I've been around a long time, and that's when I started making music in the studio. It was the kind of like late 80s, you know, it just in the beginning of 90s, kind of like when rap was first coming out, you know, all that Rap is Delight and Curtis Blow and all that stuff, and that kind of led into the 90s. So right. I got a taste of, like, you know, the very, very beginning, you know, from, you know, young guy becoming a DJ. So, man, I can appreciate those, the beginning years, the 90s, you know, and a little bit of the new stuff. But,
right.
I don't know, you know what I'm saying? It's hard to compete against some of those songs.
Nah, not too much of the new stuff for me, man.
I
can't even listen really to the mainstream radio right now, pretty much, man. It's so diluted, you know?
I hear you. It's a lot has to do with technology and a lot of the younger generation getting into producing, and there's not as much creativity as there was back in the day.
Yeah, it's the originality levels right now are definitely going low, you know?
I hear you. So tell us, like, how did you get started? How long have you been doing this, and what made you want to get into it?
Wow, man. Well, the first time, I've been around doing this maybe for like 10, 15 years, man, going at it hard, man, you know? Definitely. And, you know, I got started with my cousin. We was young and wild. And we started off basically doing like remixes of other people's songs, like goofing around on some weird Al Yankovic type shit. And then before you know it, man, you just got serious with it, man. Started writing our own songs, you know?
So you started out just having fun, goofing around, and then you realized you really, really liked it, man.
Yeah.
So that's cool, man. What were some of your earlier influences when you did start to take it seriously?
Oh, man, when I did start to take it seriously, it's pretty much like artists like Rakim, Big Daddy Kane, Wu-Tang, Nas, Mobb Deep, Boot Camp, you know, a whole bunch of heads, man, you know, that golden era sound.
Absolutely.
Cool.
Tracktion, do you have a piece of that song that he won with last week? We just hear like a little.
Yeah, I was just looking for it. Give me 1 second. Found the two for today, and I was like, all right, good, I have those.
All right, shout out to 495 boys too, man, you know.
Yes,
it was a good battle, man.
It was good. We had fun that night. I like when you have artists that you could tell that you guys are doing your thing and you got your following and you know people believe in you guys, and just like 495 boys and you,
right.
You could feel it from the fans, you know, and that's good, because a lot of people don't have that. You know, we've had a lot of people on the show, and sometimes, you know, these guys, they try hard and, you know, they sound okay, but they just don't know how to market themselves and gather that fan base. So you guys definitely prove yourself, so I just want to shout you out.
Well, you know, it's definitely not an easy industry, man, you know. A lot of people are just not getting any love, man, you know, and there's definitely a lot of talented cats that just don't get no exposure, you know, and people just don't call in for them, man, but they definitely deserve as much love as the artists that are getting it.
There's a lot of action going on in the chat room, man, so...
So bringing it back to Rakim and the Fat Boys and Grandmaster Flash back there in the chat room right now.
That stuff. That's what it was all at.
Shout out to Menace and Listen. And so let's hear something, because
I got last week's track, but you know what? I got one of the new tracks too.
Let's hear
and
that.
And it got, again, it just got that that classic vibe to it, that feel, you know? So we're gonna get into high voltage.
All right, you want to introduce this in any way? You want to say anything about it?
Well, this is the title track to the album High Voltage right here, produced by my man Don Fiducci out in CP, man. Shout out to him. And yeah, man, this is a high energy joint right here, man.
Cool, let's get it in. Traction, strongisland.com.
I'm a live wire, entirely exposed. The man grazed me and his vitals froze. Stop ticking, you dropped in an instant to the floor, crawling like an infant. Electrocute me, the roof vision. I shock your lungs like a puncture filling. That is rupturing inside of your chest. To let you know this ain't the punk you're dealing with. You can't turn me off at the disconnect switch. So my electricity is traveling to your heart, stopping its mobility apart. You rest in peace, but you gain invisibility. This is one of my many abilities I utilize on a long line of enemies. Come one by one or ton by ton, I'm like Santa with something for all of them. Electric chairs lined up in my front yard, my backyard, even where I park my car. Plenty for any who try to bogart. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage. Step to me and feel my electrons going through your spectrum. Electric charges discharging, alarms ring after bombardment. More bodies in a rubble than ground zero. I hate the stench of dead wannabe heroes. An overload or an overdose of murals, plural. Get close enough and I'll kick you like judo. Barbarian strength, I pick up sumos. You know the traits that I inherited, I'm merited and well credited. No sentiments, no mercy either. I had a falling out with one of my brother's keepers. Fuck 6 feet, I'ma bury him deeper and keep blasting the streets with nothing but heaters. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage. You don't wanna meet me, you'd rather meet the Reaper. Cause even him I'll be giving the creepers. When you hear my voice coming through the speakers, to the Don Fiducci beats I beat up. Bloodied up your Gucci from your feet up. Foes get blown away like a weed puff. I'm crippling niggas, I can't get enough. First I dismantle, then I'm dismissing them. Voltage equivalent to nuclear missiles. Coaches don't survive when I got issues. Electric currents going through your skin tissue. I'm telling your fam to get ready to miss you. I've never been funny, I ain't tickling. Shit is serious, your life fluid is trickling. I'm just better, I got the advantages. My amperages are causing internal damages. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage. When I get angry, that's when I electrify, electrocute. To execute solo acts of groups, and I crank up the amps with high voltage.
Cool, so that was Last Measure, High Voltage. That's the title track off the album?
Yeah, that's the title track right there, man. That's basically the one that's gonna amp up the whole album, you know what I mean?
All right. I got, you know what that kind of reminded me of? I don't know if you remember the dude Buck 50 back in the day, and like and Nonfiction and stuff, like kind of that kind of vibe, you know what I'm saying?
That underground, all underground,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but you got the voice for it, so your voice is rough, so it kind of...
That little, I got a little raspiness in me, you know what
nice,
I mean?
Nice, nothing wrong with that. So, yeah, that's cool. So how do you go about, like, you know, like producing? Do you have a producer that kind of puts it all together for you? Or do you have a guy who does your beats and records you? What's your process?
Well, I normally make beats myself, man, but just for some reason, I just can't rhyme to my beats, man. I don't know what that is all about. But
that's like,
that's right,
like the
now,
opposite,
man,
of the Kanye effect right there.
Yeah, it's just like right now I'm just gotta right now I'm just using beats off buying them off the internet right now, and then I got a couple of people around the way like Don Paducci from CP who contributed to the album production and stuff like that as well, you know.
All right, cool. So you're working on this album, it's all done. It's actually just now it's coming out. It's all done. What's the date that it's actually going to be available for purchase?
It's going to be available for purchase December.